Hello. Walking around my neighborhood, I've seen a lot of rainbows like this one. But I really like seeing a rainbow like this. It was raining the other day, so I went out looking for one, and I didn't see one. But then I went outside today and made my own rainbow using this. And you can do that too. Now, this is just a spray bottle. You can buy spray bottles at the hardware store. This one had some fabric treatment in it, and I poured out what was left. I saved it in a jar so I can put it back later. And if you're not an adult, you should probably work with an adult in your household if you're going to find a spray bottle like this one. I took my spray bottle outside and I started making water droplets in the sunshine, and I did find some rainbows. It was a windy day, so it was difficult. I bet on a calm day I could do better, and I bet you could do better too. Here are some hints for making a good rainbow. If you try this, the shadow where your head is marks the spot on the ground that's exactly opposite of where the sun is. But that's not where you should spray, because a rainbow is separated from that spot by about 42 degrees. That's about two full hand spans. So away from your head, about two hand spans, is where you should be spraying and looking for a rainbow. But there's a problem with this picture that I've taken. It's very sunny, and you do need sun on the water droplets, but the background is also bright with sunlight, and that can be a problem for seeing the rainbow. So when I made this rainbow, I explored a little bit and found a place where I could spray the water droplets into the sunshine, but the shadow of a building was in the background to make a darker background, and then the rainbow showed up a little better. The colors in the rainbow change depending on the size of the droplets. If they're too small, you get just a tinge of bluish on one edge and a tinge of reddish on the other. You can experiment with different kinds of spraying. If you have access to a garden hose, I should have tried to use that. You can sometimes get much better colors. But the colors in a rainbow made by real raindrops are almost always much more vivid. I think I need to do a video on those colors because they teach scientists a lot about what's in the sky near Earth and what's in the sky in space. There's one more thing I want you to know about the rainbows that you see in the sky and the rainbows that you create with a spray bottle. What I want you to know is that if you're watching a rainbow with someone else, you're actually watching different rainbows. And I could try to explain with a diagram like this. What you should know about diagrams like this is they show rays of light, but they don't show all the rays of light in the picture. That would just be too much. It just shows the ones that might be important to an explanation. So take this ray of sunlight shining down from the sun, which is over there somewhere. It shines near the person's head and onto the ground, and so it hits the ground near where the person's shadow is. This ray of light helps explain the person's shadow. This ray of light is hitting a raindrop. And when light hits a spherical raindrop, and small raindrops are round like a ball, spherical, it reflects and refracts to make a cone of light that's about 42 degrees more or less from the axis. And I say more or less because different colors spread out different amounts, which is why we see colors in a rainbow. This diagram is not so great at explaining color because everything's orange. Well, anyway, the important light is the light that gets back to your eyes because it goes in all directions in this cone. But what you see is the light that comes to your eye. And the light that's coming to your eye is different from the light that's coming to anyone else's eye. So if someone else is watching your rainbow, they're seeing different light from different raindrops. This rainbow that you see belongs to you. You might have to replay that last bit to try to make sense of it, or go on the internet for other diagrams and explanations of how rainbows are formed. It's fascinating, but kind of tricky. Or just gaze and enjoy. And here's a reminder about something completely different. If you're watching this video before May 21st, 2020, don't forget on that day, Venus and Mercury will be lined up as seen from Earth, just a little to the north of west, very low in the sky just after sunset. And if you're anywhere near the San Francisco Bay, the International Space Station will be flying by at that time soon. So check them out.